Hey friends, what's going on? This is Adil, and today we are going to talk about how to make summary from a huge amount of data in Microsoft Excel within a few minutes. Okay, I think without wasting more time, I think we should start. Okay friends, here we have sample data, and here I have this data. This is about 5000. See, this is about 5000 rows in this data, and we will make summary from this data. First of all, what we will do, we can make this data by pressing Ctrl plus T. We will convert this data into table. Okay, this has been converted into table. Now what we will do, we will make lists from this table. See, I have been selected these three columns, and I will go to formula and will click here, create from selection. See, here a window pops up. I will uncheck this box, and I will check this box top row, create names from values in top row. Okay, I will click OK, and see, here we can check here three lists has been created. One, customer name, this is customer name, this list has been created. Second one is invoice amount, this list has been created. And third one is units delivered, this is units delivered, this list has been created. Okay, now what we will do, we will make summary from this table. Okay, I will go to data and will click here filters. I will click here advanced filters, and see, here we want to filter list in place, we want to copy to another location. What we want to copy, from which data we want to copy, I will select range, from which range I want to copy. I will select this range, this complete range, and I need only unique values because I need to make summary. So I will copy only unique values from this data. I will check this box and will copy to on which location I want to copy. I want to copy here in H column. So I will click here and will select H column and will click OK, and see, these are all unique values. This is first one is heading customer name. I will make this heading, I'm making it bold, and these remaining are all customer names. These are unique values. We have total how many? 8 customers, but here we have 5000 rows for these customers. Okay, we have only 8 customers. Now what we will do, we want this amount, invoice amount. So here I will write total amount, and what I will do, I will check XYZ company how much we need to receive from this customer, XYZ company. I will insert here a formula function, if sum if. I will go here and open function arguments, and which range sum if, when I want to make sum, when this range, which range, this range is equal to, this range is equal to this, I want to sum. What I want to sum? I want to sum these values. Okay, I click OK, and see, this is total amount, this is total amount that we have receivable from our XYZ company. We will copy all this formula, and see, sum if this amount, this column is equal to this value H3, this value ABC company. What sum? This column, this amount, in sum the invoice amount. Okay, so I will make it in accounting format with dollar sign. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to count how many invoices I have. Here I have invoice amount. These are all invoices. So I want to count how many invoices I have for XYZ customer. So I will insert here a formula count if, and I will open formula function argument count if, this range is equal to this. Okay, total 528 invoices. I will copy this formula down. We have 528 invoices for XYZ company customer, 527 invoices for ABC customer, and 526 invoices for McDonald's, for KFC 789. Okay, now I want to make average amount per invoice. What I will do, average if function argument, average if this range is equal to which, this one, and average what I want to average, I want to average these all 5000 rows. When in this column, when in column B the value is equal to this XYZ company, I want to make average all these values, all values in D column, when XYZ, when here value in B column is equal to XYZ company. I will click OK and see, this is average. I will remove these fractions and make copy here down, and these are average amount per invoice. Here is this formula is useful in all versions of Microsoft Excel, but only in those friends who are using Excel 2003 this formula is not available in Excel 2003. So we can use simple average. We will make equal this total amount that we have receivable from our customers divided by total number of invoices. So this is, sorry, general, and remove these fractions and down. See, this is same, answer is same. So now I will pick this all ranges table format and see, this is summary of this whole data. See, there, here we have about 5000 rows, but here in summary what we have only 8 rows. Okay friends, for now I think it's enough. Okay friends, don't forget to like and share this video, and please also don't forget to subscribe our channel. Okay friends, bye bye.